Hi guys, so I'm about to show you the natural remedy or organic remedy to chronic respiratory disease or CRD in chickens. Welcome back to DIY Hagrid, your number one animal scientist and your poultry success partner. If you want to make maximum profit in broiler farming or poultry farming generally, then you have to know how to take care or tackle CRD. Like I always say, most of the birds that we get come with mycoplasma from the hatchery, and CRD is just a matter of time. It wants to surface, so you need something to suppress it all the time. And that's one of the reasons why we have devised a natural means of curing or preventing CRD among our broiler flock or in any chicken farm for that matter. So right now I'm going to be showing you all that we are going to use. We have here, we have our lime juice, and we have some seeds that I've crushed here. I'm going to be telling you the names very quickly so that you get to know them. This one too is another seed I'm going to be showing you, and this is ginger. We have the popular garlic, and we have the cayenne pepper. I'm going to make sure to put the scientific names of all the things that we are using so you get to see them. So as I mentioned their real names, I will show you the scientific names so you can know it regardless of where you are watching from, whether you are watching from Uganda or Rwanda or the UK or the US, wherever you are watching from, you will be able to get them. Okay, so I have a blender here also, and I have this blender because I had to blend these seeds here into powder form, because until you blend it into powder form, you may not be able to get the effectiveness. And if you want to try to do that in a blender like this, you may not be able to break the seeds. Okay, so let's just go right into the video. We're going to be experimenting with these. We're going to be using the chickens that we have there, our December broilers. We're going to be using them. We're going to be using this to treat them for CRD. Okay, so I'm going to get my scale now because it's very important. And in case you have attended the course or you have my books, I have books and I have the course that deals with all these things and even much more. So if you take the course, you'll be able to have it as a guide. Even right here, I'm using my notes as a guide for the measurement. So I have first the lemon, which you can just get two average size of lemon. So I'll be putting the scientific name on the screen. Yeah, of lemon. So I'm going to be using this as my lemon. Instead of getting the two average size lemon, I'll just use this, and you know, probably two capful would do. Two capful should do for two average size lemon. So I think I should be putting them inside the blender here. Okay, so let me get this on one side. The last time I tried to use this here, it messed up the whole table. But right now it's, I think it's tight. Yeah, it's locked into position. Okay, so where is our scale? Let me put this aside. This is all practical. So you want to make sure you watch the whole video. I'll be showing you all this in detail. All right, now we are about to start taking our measurements. I'm going to leave the two average size lemon to after I've poured the rest into the blender and I'm ready to blend. Okay, so all these, we are going to be using 500 mils of water to blend. So now we had the fennel seeds, Okay, so this is what we call the fennel seeds. Okay, it has been crushed. The seeds have been crushed into somewhat powdery form. And it is until you do this that you perceive some really strong aroma. And that means you are letting out the effectiveness of these seeds. So we are going to be using how many grams of it? 10 grams. And we have our scale ready at zero. So we are going to be taking 10 grams. Watch as we go. Okay, I think we still have a long way to go. 7, 8, 9 and okay, 10. Okay, so that's 10 grams of fennel seeds, and we are to add about 50 grams of ginger, and this is what we call ginger. So I think I should tie it again. I should tie the scale and start for ginger. Okay, so this is what we call ginger. Don't mind me, I'm not going to remove the back. Yeah, I'm not going to remove the back. Okay, so we are taking 50 grams of ginger. That's 49. I actually measured that before. And we'll have about 51, 52. Okay, so let's let the 2 grams represent the back, which we do not need. Okay, so we have that taken care of. Ginger is taken care of. And we'll move on to garlic. We need 50 grams of garlic as well. So let me tie it again and then add garlic. This is garlic. This also, I'm not removing the back. If you remove the back, this is what it's going to look like. Okay, so this is garlic. I believe you can see it clearly now. Okay, one wonderful property of garlic is that it has allicin. When it has allene, and when that allene is crushed, when the garlic is crushed, the allene is converted into allicin, and allicin is effective against mycoplasma, and it's also effective against a couple of diseases. But we are not focusing on that in this. We are getting 50 grams of garlic. This is the product of lots and lots of research work. And a lot of trials and experiments. So you guys are benefiting from all this. So if you think the video is deserving of a like, a thumbs up, please go ahead and give us a thumbs up. And if you're here to subscribe to the channel, you would want to do that right now, because there's a lot to benefit from DIY agri. Okay, we have 50 grams already, but again, to cover for the back, for the peel, let's just add a few grams, and that's 2 grams. Or let me have this, 3 grams to cover for that. Okay, so the next we need now is the Ajwain seeds. Okay, so we have fennel seed, we have the ginger, we have the garlic, we have the Ajwain seed, and we need 4 tablespoons of honey. 4 tablespoons of honey, and then okay, I'll add honey when it's all in the blender. I'll add honey and lemon. So now let me add the last one on the list, which is cayenne pepper, and this is our cayenne pepper. Okay, let's start this, and it's 50 grams of cayenne pepper. 50 grams of cayenne pepper. I needed to take my time to show you guys this in detail, so there's no need to rush. It's a practical. Okay, so this is 54 grams. We are just going to, because if we remove one now, we have less than 50, and I don't want to cut, so that's 4 grams extra. Wouldn't hurt. Okay, so this is what we should put inside our blender, and we need 500 mils of water. I have inside my glass jar. This is a 2-liter glass jar, and I have 500 mils of water. So I'm going to be adding everything into the blender now, and then we'll add the lime and honey. So let's start blending. Okay, now let me just pour all that we have inside the blender. I think it would be good to have some water in the blender first, so the powdery ingredients does not stick to the bottom. Okay, so because of the powder, you have to make this gentle. Okay, and I'll try to rinse off. Okay, I don't want to make a mess today. Okay, and I can add the rest of the water. So blend with all this. Wow, this is looking so good. And the birds are going to enjoy their life. Okay, so for the two medium size, in the description of this video, I'm going to be leaving the ingredients that you need to prepare this. So for the two medium size lemon, let me add this 2 cupful of lemon juice. Did I say lemon juice? This is lime. So you can either use lemon or lime for this. Lemon or lime. Not lemonade. Yeah, this bottle is actually for lemonade. I got lemonade to drink and I'm just using the bottle. Alright, this is my honey for this purpose, and it says 4 tablespoons of honey. You see, these guys are taking honey, they are really enjoying. 4 tablespoons. We're gonna blend all this together. Well, I could say that it's not compulsory that you had honey before you blend, because you can just add the honey after blending. But I want to make sure that everything we are using, because some people are not going to watch the video to the end, it has just been like that. I want to try as much as possible to let everyone see all that we are using. Okay, now is the time to blend. We are done with all that we want to add. So if you just blend from this point, then you have your CRD prevention and treatment medication. Okay, I'm just going to remove this from here. Let me check if you are having a clear view. Okay, quite clear. Okay, so we'll start blending now. Just like I told you, you can see we have some particles, I think the inside of the pepper and all that. So if you don't blend the fennel seed, as you can see, those things are so tiny. The seeds are so tiny. So if you don't blend it inside a dry matter or dry ingredient blender, they may not get crushed inside this. So it's important that you have them in powder form before you get to this stage, so that they are useful. You know, if your birds don't eat them up in the drink, then that means it's just wasting away. And you know, when you want to crush things like the ginger, you need a powerful blender. So it's important that you get a powerful blender to do the job. Okay, I think we are close. And I'm going to be saving everything. I'm storing it inside this glass jar. Alright, so I'll be storing it inside this jar, and then we'll proceed to the chicken house to put it inside their water, and then I'll be telling you about the dosage. Thank you.
Yeah.
All right, the birds are actually thirsty now, and I just went to get these measuring cups from the people that sell catering supplies. Okay, so these are measuring cups. We have up to 250 mils, 125, 83, 62, 31. So I guess we'll be making use of the 31 for now. Okay, so the dosage is 50 mils to 4 liters, 50 mils of this solution to 4 liters of water. And what we have inside the drinkers are containing just 3 liters. So that is, if 50 mils is to go to 4 liters, then 25 is to go to 2, and 37.5 to 3 liters. So we have, this one says 31 mils. So I'm going to use this and then try to get a little to represent the remaining 6.5. This is 31 mils. Okay. So let me use this and just a little. Yeah. For each of them. Okay, so if you are putting this if you are supplying through the automatic drinkers, I would still advise that you use a sieve for this. Yeah. So that you don't get the particles inside the drinker hose. All right, so this is what we have for each of the drinkers. We are ready to serve them. They are thirsty already. Okay. So right now we say we are treating or preventing chronic respiratory disease with what we have just served them. Okay. Okay. So let's see if they love it. Yeah, they're actually tasty, and you can see them crowding the water. You can see them flying and crowding the water. They are doing good. They are also out of feed, so I'll be supplying them with feed. So that's about preventing or treating chronic respiratory disease or CRD in poultry. So if you think that you like the video, please leave us a thumbs up and also subscribe to the channel if you are yet to do so. Thank you and bye bye.